until 1973, and its population is rarely more than 200 to 300 people. For over 30 years, this isolated base in the middle of the desert is shrouded in mystery. Now, reports of strange lights hovering over the base become regular, and radar captures impossibly fast objects moving in the vicinity. But secrecy remains. Then, in 1989, everything changes.
The time where I entered the hangar, I witnessed recovered alien spacecraft that the Department of Naval Intelligence in the United States was back engineering.
Alleged U.S. government physicist Bob Lazar goes public and claims he is reverse engineering alien spacecraft at Area 51. UFO sightings in the airspace above Groom Lake skyrocket. But the base remains closed off. An outer perimeter of at least 15 miles prevents anyone from seeing the installation. People who try to cross the perimeter are chased off, face arrest, and are warned that deadly force for trespassers is authorized. But now, using new high-definition cameras, there may be a way in.
We're only a few miles away from the beating heart central.
It's the most secret military base on the planet.
You wanted Area 51. There it is.
But no one's ever been this close until now.
This is the place to be at the right time.
What is the government hiding inside? Is it secret weapons or extraterrestrial technology?
We're taking it apart to figure out how it works.
And what happens when people venture too far?
We actually had to jump into the car to protect ourselves.
Now, declassified information, inside accounts, revelations from former CIA pilots.
I saw a flying saucer.
And a groundbreaking look at the base with state-of-the-art equipment.
We're getting images of Area 51 in high definition, the likes of which people have never seen before.
This is case number 55101, Area 51 revealed.
It's huge.
October